Good morning, children. Today, let me take one lesson for you. Yesterday, I told you to mark that is to write. Today, you are giving that is to write a letter to your friend. Write a letter to your friend, inviting him to attend your village fair. So, write a letter to your friend, inviting him to attend your village fair. So, write on the postcard, write the letter, and on the back side, write your from address and to address and post it to the post office. So try to do it. It is the mobile for even. Now let us take one question, that is Deepa's generation. Lesson number 16. Open page number 131. Page number 131. Deepa's generation. Let us see. Very interesting lesson. If you are ready, I will be starting the lesson. See, look page number 131. Now, from this lesson, what you are going to study is that you know the relationship between the members of the three generations of the family and draw a simple family tree. See, what you are going to learn is you must know your parents, you are younger, but you must know your grandparents also. That's what your grandparents and your great grandparents. That's what. Not only your father, mothers, your grandparents, and also your great grandparents also you must be knowing, understood? So, at least you must know your three generations, between the members of the three generations, that is grandparents, your father, mother, and yours, understood? So, know the relationship between members of the three generations, that is yours is the first, a third one, your parents are the second, and first is the your grandparents and your parents and you are the third generation. This way you must know all the relationship between three generations and also by simple family tree. Recognize the similarities in physical and hereditary features among the family members. You must know how you are similar to your family members. That is you may be similar to with your pets in many of the aspects like skin color, hair, both the hair and all, eyes, ears, nose, laughing, walking style and all, you may be same. It is they are the physical features and some hereditary features will be there like singing, acting, drama and all. Maybe they will be from your sisters, that is parents, they are maybe your hereditary features means they may come from your grandparents or great grandparents, the like acting, dancing, singing and all, they may be from your ancestors. So they may be called some are physical and some are hereditary features and from among the family members. Besides the relationship of the child and the mother. Also, let us study about the relationship of the child and the mother. Now, here is the lesson. Now, Raju and Deepa are two children and they are came to their grandparents' house during the summer vacation. See, like how you are going to your grandparents' house during vacation and all, during summer vacation, you will be going to your grandparents' house. The same way, Raju and Deepa are the two children of your age. They had gone to their grandparents' house during the vacation. Raju, Deepa and their mother and grandmother went to neighboring village. One day, Raju and Deepa, they got to grandparents. They come to their grandparents' house. And the next day, Raju, Deepa and their mother and grandmother, they went to the neighboring village. They went to nearby village to attend their naming ceremony. They went to the neighboring village to attend the function, that is naming ceremony. Kannada English word is neighboring village means nearby village to attend the naming ceremony means Nesiradu Karakram. Namakaranam. Understood? Naming ceremony means Namakaranam Karakram. Many people had gathered there and Deepa saw a small baby in the garden. Many people, their relatives and friends had gathered there. And Deepa and saw a small baby in the garden. And you can see the picture here. Many of the relatives that saw had been gathered together there. And the baby was in the garden. You can see the garden's purple water bottle. It was the picture. The garden was in the garden. And while looking at it, Deepa asked her mother, "Mother, whose baby is this?" Deepa asked her mother, "That whose baby is this?" Mother told, "Deepa, it is the baby of Radha and Raju. Deepa, it is the baby of Radha and Raju. And you too used to sleep in the cradle like this when you were a baby." So mother told that it is the baby of Radha and Raju, and they are the parents of newly born baby. And you too used to sleep in the cradle when you were a baby. Mother told to the Deepa. And now, next, the baby in the cradle started crying, and Radha took the baby into her bosom and consoled it by singing a lullaby. So, after some time, the baby was sleeping in the cradle, and started crying. And Radha took the baby to her bosom and consoled it by singing a lullaby. When the baby started crying, Radha took her baby into her bosom and she consoled it by singing a lullaby. When she started, she took her in her bosom and she consoled it, and she made it stop by singing it. Radha made her baby to stop by singing a lullaby. Lullaby means jogla. Lullaby means jogla. Now here is given here. The lullaby is given here. Listen. Aluva kaltana tutti yu. Avalada kudi hanga. Kudi kumku baby nesari nanga. Karnota shivana kayyolo avalada hanga. So, someplace given here, what is the meaning of this lullaby means? A crying child's lips means tutti, what you call them, look like a pearl. Pearl means diamond. Should pearl means muttu, what you call them. And its tender rose appear like a petals of new flower. Its tender rose appears like a petals of a new flower. Galla, look like a petals of a neem flower. Baby Neligati rose will be high. And its dear filled eyes flash like a sharp edge of a Lord Shiva's sword. And even its tearful petals of the tearful eyes. It is like just like a sharp edge of Lord Shiva's sword. And listening to the sound, the baby stopped crying. And this is the end. Now here, observe the pictures, these pictures say how a mother cares for her child. You can see it in the picture how the animals to take care of their animals. You can see it, the baby. Monkey is holding its baby and it is sitting on the tree. And second picture, you can see the bird, it is feeding its young ones with its beak. And even the hen, it is teaching the young ones to search the grains. And also mother, the picture of the baby and the mother, how she is showing love towards her child. You can see the observe the pictures how the mothers they are taking care of her. You can see the mother monkey how it is holding its baby and sitting there. And you can see the bird, it is feeding its very much. The hen, it is taking its baby and egg ones with there along with it. But you can see how the shift towards the baby. So these are how mother take care of their young ones. So in all these situations, mother fulfills all the needs of the child, such as love, nurture, affection, and etc. So mother takes or fulfills means she takes care of all the needs of the child. She shows love and she protects her baby and also provides for the creator by time to time. This way she takes care of the child. Now we open page number 183. First column. While returning from the leaving ceremony, grandmother met her friends. On the way, grandmother met her friends and they looked at Raju and said, "He looks like just like a grandfather." Grandmother's friends, they saw the Raju and said, "Raju is looking like a just like grandfather." So his eyes, broad, red, long nose, resembled his grandfather. Deepa said, "Everyone they say that I resemble my mother. See, I have curly hair. My mother too has a curly hair." So Deepa said that I too resemble like my mother. The similarities are same among the mother and the grandfather and the grandson, mother and the daughter. So see, I have curly hair. My mother too has a curly hair. Because of her mother's curly hair, the daughter Deepa also having the curly hair. And whom do you resemble in your family? Observe carefully and write that. Write his or her name in relationship with you. You can write here. Now here, the picture of family is given here. Identify the similarities you notice among them and write here. So you can see how the grandparents and their parents, how they were grandfather, father. You can see how they are similar. Here, grandfather and Ravi and mother and Ramya. So all of them they resemble their grandparents or parents and grandparents. So here, children resemble their parents, grandparents and other members of the family. Generally, the similarities can be seen in the hair. Sometimes the hair, their hair will be same, color of the skin may be same, and the eyes, ears, nose, walking and laughing style also may be same, may be similar, same. They met Ramappa, the grandfather, on the way, who was returning from the town. And he took the children to the farm. One more person they met on the way, they met Ramappa. He was the grandfather. The grandfather on the way was returning from the town. He took the children to the farm. Farm is Pala Vatikal. Now Deepa said, "Grandpa, how many children do you have?" So grandfather told them about his family. Grandfather told Deepa, your grandmother is Uttama. We have two children. They are your father, Subhana, and your aunt Leela." So grandfather told Deepa that your grandmother is Uttama. And we have two children. They are your father, one, that is Subhana, and your aunt Leela. Subhana and Leela are the They are the brother and sister. And you and Raju are the two children of your father. And I, your grandmother, your father, mother, you and Raju, thus belong to three generations. This is the grandfather, grandmother. It is Ramappa as a Ramappa and Uttamma are the grandparents. And Subhadanda is the father. And Raju and Deepa are the third generation. So Deepa told the grandfather, "I could not really understand what you said." So Raju said, "Deepa, I have learned about the generations in the school. It can be drawn, shown by drawing a simple family tree. I will draw and show you what grandfather said. Then you will understand it." Children reached home. So Deepa said, "Raju, you told me about the family tree. Will you please draw it and show me? Take this pencil and draw paper." So Raju, "Okay, look here. So, I should draw the picture of the family tree and show Deepa. It looks like a tree, Raju said. It is called a family tree. It is a simple family tree of Raju's family. You can see it. This is called a family tree. And you can see the main branch and the sub branches. And you can the main stem is the first generation. That is grandfather and grandmother. And these are the second one. It is father and mother, it is second generation. And Raju and Deepa are the third generation. So by drawing family tree, we can show the three generation. Understood? So that tree is compared to the our family. Understood? By looking this, we can understand what is generation. So about generation, we can know about this. How the grandparents, this is the main partner, and this is second one. In the father, mother, Raju, Deepa, third generation. This is the first, second, third generation can be seen by drawing the family tree. Understood? So as the tree is also compared to the family members. Now here, next, Raju, grandfather. You may have shown me a big tree in the farm, haven't you? Grandfather told him. I planted that tree when I was in. Now it is very big, Raju said. There was another big tree beside that grandpa. Grandfather told him. Oh, that was planted by your father when he was in. It is small tree. It grew well, Raju said. Grandfather, tomorrow Deepa and I will plant a sapling beside those trees. The grandfather said, well, Raju, let it grow also grow like you. So this is about the Deepa's generation. So Deepa is the third generation. Our parents are second, and then Deepa is the third generation. Deepa and Raju. Their parents are second and grandparents are the first generation. So here, let me tell you about the processes on the board. Okay, questions. Your first answer for the questions. First question: why did Raju and Deepa came to their grandparents' house? Raju and Deepa and their parents went to neighboring village to attend naming ceremony function. Who are the parents of newly born baby? Raja and Raju are the parents of newly born baby. Understood? Now, how did Raju console? Radha consoled her. Consoled her baby when crying. Radha took the baby into her bosom and consoled it by singing a lullaby. Actually, what is lullaby? Jogula Buddha. How the mother fulfills all the needs of the child? Mother fulfills all the needs of the child, such as love, nurture, protection, food, etc. How do children resemble their parents, grandparents, and family members? Generally, the similarities can be seen in the hair, skin color, eyes, ears, nose, walking, smile, laughing, etc. So these are the two questions of the observation, and this is the family tree shown by all the generations. That is first generation, grandfather, grandmother, first generation. Father, mother is the second generation. Raju and Deepa is the third generation. So this is the family tree. Showing the generation. So these are processes you can write in your classwork. And also homework. Second time. So this is about the lesson, Deepa's lesson. You can take it in your classwork. So this completes the lesson, Deepa's lesson. Thank you.